Hi, this is Oscar Gori. I'm going to show you in this video today how to set up a yum repository for CentOS Linux version 7 and make this repo accessible from another CentOS system. For this demonstration, I have two virtual machines in VirtualBox loaded with CentOS 7, and their host names are Server 1 and Station 1. I'm going to configure the yum repo on Server 1 and then configure access to it on both Server 1 and Station 1 via the HTTP protocol. Please note that I have already attached the CentOS ISO image on Server 1. Also note that this procedure applies to Red Hat Enterprise Linux and all its derivatives. Okay, here are the steps that I'm going to run on Server 1. The first step is to mount the ISO image onto MNT, which is an empty directory available for such uses. Mount minus O read-only slash dev slash CD-ROM on MNT. And we verify with the df command, and as you can see in the output at the very bottom, the CD-ROM is mounted on MNT directory. Next, we install a software package called create repo that we are going to use to build our repo. We use the yum command for the installation. Yum local install slash MNT slash packages slash create repo minus Y for confirmation. Oops, the package is already there. Now we'll create a directory called CentOS 7 under var www.html using the mkdir command. We're going to use the minus P option because currently var www does not exist. Seven directory is created. Now we're going to copy all the packages located under slash MNT slash packages directory on the CD-ROM drive to this new CentOS 7 folder using the tar command. CD MNT packages and then tar cf dash asterisk pipe CD www.html CentOS and then tar xvf dash and press the enter key. This will take about 3.7 gigabytes of disk space. Make sure that you do not run out of space. Okay, the copy is done. Now we're going to create a repo file under etc yum.repos.d directory. And let's call this file centos7.repo. Open it up in the VI editor and centos7repo is the repo ID. Comments CentOS 7 repository base URL file colon slash 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 var www.html CentOS 7 enabled equals 1 GPG check. We don't want any GPG checks. Save the file and exit out of the VI editor. Now we're going to run the yum clean all command to clean the yum cache from any previous repo data. And then we're going to run yum repo list. And as you can see, under the status column, there are 3,538 packages that are available from this repo right now. Finally, we're going to install the Apache HTTPD software and start the HTTPD service to make the repo accessible over the HTTP protocol from remote servers. We're going to use the yum minus y for confirmation install httpd command line. And as you can see, the package installation and all the dependent packages installation is complete. We will also need to modify the base URL in this file again to point to the http://, hostname is 192.168.0.200 is the IP address of this host. Save the file and exit out. Make sure that the httpd service is marked for automatic start at system reboot. And let's start the service now. Systemctl start httpd. The service has been started. To confirm that the repo is now accessible over HTTP, we're going to run the yum repo list command again. And it shows the same data. Let's clean the yum cache again, yum clean all, and then run yum repo list. Oops, there's an error message there, and there's something wrong, and we're unable to access httpd based repository. So it must be SE Linux preventing from accessing it. So let's do one thing, cd /var ll -d z www, and use this command, restore con minus r and v. /var/www. And let's try it again. Yum repo list. And all the files are accessible now. And everything is all set on this system. Now we're going to log on to station 1 and configure access to this repository over the network. But before we go and start doing work on station 1, let's add the service, httpd service, to the firewall configuration. Firewall cmd --permanent --add service equals http and firewall -cmd --reload. All done on server 1. On station 1, I'm already logged in. Host name is right here, station1.example.com. Make sure that we are able to ping 192.168.0.200, which is the IP of server 1, and it works fine. So let's cd into the etc yum.repos.d directory and create a file, repo file here. Let's call it CentOS 7.repo as well. ID CentOS 7.repo. It doesn't have to be exactly the same, but base URL equals http://192.168.0.200/CentOS7. Enable equals 1, GPG check equals 0, and name equals CentOS7.repo. Save the file and exit out of the VI editor, yum clean all, and then try yum repo list. And as you can see, there are 3,538 packages available from the repo we configured on server one. And let's try to install something from this repo over the network. Let's install V as FTPD software using the yum command. And the software has been installed, has installed successfully without any issues. For more information, please read my book, RHCSA and RHCE Red Hat Enterprise Linux 7 Training and Exam Preparation Guide for Exams EX200 and EX300 3rd Edition. Thank you for watching this video. Bye now.